Why is it that even beautiful women, bad bitches, are single today? It's simple. Feminism. Feminism taught you women that you a queen, you God's gift to this earth, you the prize. No, the fuck you ain't. No, you ain't. You ain't a queen. You ain't never gonna be my queen because you ain't my mother. You don't love me unconditionally. You love me under conditions. And the problem is that I'm a man. I'm a leader. I'm the toxic asshole guy. The tool, right? Because when we go out, right, you expect me to take care of you, right? When we go out, I pay for it. You good. We go to the store. Hey, get some shoes. You good. I got you. But when I tell you to do something, do it. That's the problem. Don't expect me to chase you and beg you and get on my knees, bro. I'm not submissive. I'm dominant. And then what happens is, I don't want to be with that. He's toxic. He's bad. Your friends tell you he's a bad guy, right? Then you go be with the nice guy and you end up cheating on him or leaving him because he's weak. He don't make you feel nothing. He don't blow the back. That's the problem. You're the problem. You're delusional.
Hey, everyone. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Brittany Simon. We're going to try this today because my other mic went earlier and I don't know why. So I want to talk about Heartbreak Nino 617. He's a guy on TikTok. I'm sure you guys have seen him. Now, the thing about him that's so ironically interesting is that he's misogyny but entertainment. I honestly am very entertained by this type of misogyny, and I want to talk to you about it today. You know, I rolled in a lot of feminist circles way back in the day, and the thing that was so funny about it was, yes, it was comforting and community building and great, and at the same time there were a lot of really petty girls in that group who were not all really happy. One of the things I constantly saw from these groups is like a description of misogyny as this man and thinking most men were like this man. Best you been thinking about no one but me. I slide in a pussy and hit it for free. She know I'm the nigga that she really need. I'm here and she dripping right down to her feet. I bet she been thinking about no one but me. I know these little niggas ain't trying to compete. You know when she with me, she never gonna leave. You trying to fix something that can't be complete. Let's get it. What? She goes to you and ran back to the boy. I love your pussy, but girl, I need more. I wanted the money, you wanted the yore. I learned to adapt because I'm good to my core. I cannot be falling in love with a whore. I beat up the pussy till that shit is sore. You niggas ain't fucking with needle for sure. But please, hear me out when I say this. This is a 2C man, maybe even a 1. But this is a man whose misogyny is rooted in a concept or like a specific bubble of information. He's like the Fresh and Fit guys. He is their demographic. I'm assuming he watches Fresh and Fit.
So like with me, I grew up in a Muslim household. So I already kind of knew the game with like how women operate and everything like that. It wasn't until I read The Rational Male that I was able to connect everything together. Because my mom told me, like, people say, who hurt you? I was like, actually, it was my mom that told me to watch out for you chicks, bro. So, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, she was the one.
I'm guessing the Muslim upbringing gives you a little bit more of a realistic perspective, yeah, on how women operate, rather than like when I look at like my mom sort of giving me this like semi-feminist upbringing type, yeah, thing. It's like some of the shit that she tried to tell me is not really how the world fucking works.
Yeah, you know? My mom was based, man.
And what can we learn from Fresh and Fit except that it's a bunch of men who are kind of basic and really upset about it, instead of embracing their basicness, which I think is going to be the new trend in 2022. I think they're just in denial that they might be and they hate it, or that women might even want basic. Because the truth is, as I get older, I become more basic and I feel like my interests become more basic. I want a family and kids, and I want to chill in the country where I live currently. I want to hang out with my families on the weekends and celebrate 4th of July, Christmas, and Thanksgiving, have a Halloween, you know, tradition. I want to just relax. You know what I mean? I want to grow old with somebody. Pretty basic, right? But these men make it sound like these women are asking for the world. And yes, some of you women are. So please take note if you're one of those women. Are you asking for the world? And if you are, why? Why, girl? Why you want to take that on your shoulders? You have one life to live. What do you need the world for? Maybe I am just so basic. I don't want the world. I want a little slice of the pie, a very tiny slice of pie. Okay, so I went ahead and I like, you know, his TikTok's been taken down, so it's been kind of annoying to try to find a lot of his clips, but they're definitely around the internet. And there's a couple parts of them I just want to tackle with you. So the first is in relation to his queenness. He says to these women, you will never be my queen. My queen is my mother. Let's just start there, okay? His queen is his mother. Now, this says to me he grew up with a single mom, because I assume if my brothers went to my mom and was like, you my queen, my dad would be like, I'm sorry, what'd you say? How is that even reasonable to say out loud to your mom, right? That's so fucking weird, dude. That's so fucking weird, dude. And like, in terms of bubbles, like, look, I created a philosophy, an observational tool, I don't know what you want to call it. It's a 1 through 5 scale. And it's supposed to judge a person's ability to be aware of their, like, their actual existence. And so he obviously lives in a bubble that has never met, like, the people in my family, has obviously never met cute homeschooler girls, has obviously never met, like, specific kinds of people. Because if he had, he couldn't talk like this. This is a very specific way of talking. I can hear it. Like, Fresh and Fit, that's these guys, right? Fresh and Fit, they're, like, averagey guys who are a little basic, who think they deserve more. And it's strange. It's strange to watch them all rattle off. And I get it. If they're going after basic girls, that's what they're going to get. And no offense, most of the girls I've seen from Fresh and Fit are not educated. They don't bring much to the table. Half of them can't even cook. Like, what good are you? I don't even understand. And so in some ways, they're all perfect for each other, but they hate each other because they know that they're stuck with each other. And that's what I'm saying. Y'all, we're not all stuck with this man. Like, this is a specific man. I almost never meet men like this. And this is why when feminism came out in like 2015, whenever SJWness and everything was being debated on the internet, y'all painted it like men were just like Mr. Misogyny here. Men were saying crazy things like, my mom is my queen and you'll never be my queen. You'll always, you know, these ridiculous things. And then you get the mediocre kind of mid-level guys who have a little bit of red pill in them and a little bit of not red pill in them, and they get confused and everyone starts moving to bubbles and everyone gets really like, they start overlapping, but it gets confusing. Well, here's the thing. The reality is that we're all in different bubbles in the United States. It's diversity in this town. And so if you grew up here in the States, it may be in conjunction with, you know, other places surrounding, but things that are places that are similar, then you grew up with a lot of options and a lot of misunderstandings of the world if you've stayed in your bubble. And I'm telling you, this is what I'm telling you. This particular man is a particular kind of person. Right? Listen to his language. He says feminism is the reason women are single. He's gotten this from other people. Fresh and Fit talk about this, all the way to Jordan Peterson. Like, these are not the same people, though. Jordan Peterson is not Fresh and Fit, right? Even though they all get associated because feminists are dumb and don't know how to separate people into proper categories, they look the same. They are not the same. And they don't actually even look the same if you have any observational tools at your disposal. So here's the deal. Women are unhappy, and you can blame feminism. You can blame the two household incomes for the economy boosting the way it doesn't house prices moving up. You can blame a lot of things on a lot of things on a lot of things. But here's what it gets down to. You want more freedoms? There are consequences. You want to decide to ban other people from living their life? There are consequences. I think it's really silly that we're not embracing the choices we have made. Look, I know the choices I've made. I'm not a feminist anymore. I don't need to be a part of a subculture that tells me I'm constantly wrong for everything that I do. Bored, boring, not interested. You know what's more interesting, though? Realizing that regardless of me leaving feminism, it did help me become independent. Oh, it did. It really did. Like, I honestly got better because of it, because it was what I needed at the time. And now I'm chilling. I'm moving away from my subcultures because they remain stagnant. And now I'm doing other things with my life that lead me to remaining single. But it's not just about feminism. I live out in the country. I live in a small town. I don't go on dating apps. I'm more of a traditionalist, but I also do OnlyFans. Like, at the end of the day, I'm obviously not the category of women like Mr. Misogynist is dating. I'm obviously a queer person, hopefully, obviously. I'm obviously a person that's really left, but not leftist politics. You know, there's a lot of things about me that make me undateable. And it's not just because feminism. It's because we're realizing as we're getting older that settling is not going to be healthy for us. That at the end of the day, I'm not going to be one of those women who goes, yeah, I guess I'll settle if it means not dying old. Like, there was a woman on Fresh and Fit who legit said, I'd rather settle for a guy who wants an open relationship than remaining single. And I'm telling you, my girl, you do not need men. You do not need them. You don't. You don't. Men, you do not need women. You do not. You do not need them. You're allowed to be single. You're allowed to be yourself. Or you're allowed to invest in your dating life and make moves that get you married. Now, you can do this by settling. I know a lot of people in LA who settled this year during COVID. They were so desperate. They all got married. I give them about 5 years until they get a divorce. You know, we're marrying people we don't even know, or we're marrying for the wrong reasons. But ultimately, I am a romantic. Mr. Misogynist is obviously not a romantic. Not a romantic. This isn't what a romantic says.
If I can give some dating advice to women.
Oh, fuck, you're a talker.
You, number one, there's two types of guys in this.
I'm aware.
The alpha dominant type of guys like myself.
Oh, honey, you know, you're
more of the submissive type of guy.
Good boy. Yeah, I know we're talking.
My advice to you.
Jesus Christ.
You know what I'm saying?
It's a little small, but I don't judge.
That's normal.
Yeah, whatever helps you sleep at night.
Why don't you guys, most of you guys. Try being submissive.
I did. It's not my thing. I don't know how you guys do it, to be honest.
You guys think submissiveness is bad.
What? Okay, you need to get better at reading the room.
What are you talking about?
The hell do you think I'm talking about? I'm obviously a big fucking fan.
Well, submissiveness is the most feminine trait. That's why I can't be submissive.
Oh, you're doing just fine.
It's funny. I saw a TikTok of a woman who, somebody wrote her something to the effect of like, you know, who told you could be this way? And it's like, daddy said I could or something like that. And it's like, Mr. Darcy. Listen, some of us are holding out for Mr. Darcy. Some of us are holding out for our Vegetas and Goku. Some of us are holding out for these men who are like our fathers, if we had good fathers. Some of us are just holding out for this ideal because, boo, honestly, my life is chilling. Like, my life is so fucking good. I would not change a thing about my life today unless it was finding the perfect spouse and then having my 20 kids. But otherwise, I mean, why would we, right? So Mr. Misogynist lives in a bubble in which women are desperate to get married. And frankly, his advice might make sense for the people who live in that bubble. Same with Fresh and Fit. Men wrote me and they're like, Brittany, you don't know what it's like out here. Well, boo, let me tell you. Of course I don't know what it's like out there because I'm not living in your crazy world. I'm not in your world. I literally don't live there. I live way somewhere else. And I'm just telling you, you don't have to stay there. You can get out. Unless you want to stay there, then stop complaining. Listen, I would love to get married, but let me make it very clear to you. I am not complaining about being single. It's great. I fucking love it. And at the same time, I would love being married. It's okay to want two things at the same time. Because, you know, consent is the foundation of my belief system. I would never force someone to be with me for the rest of my life unless they really wanted to be there. And so I think it's just silly to be desperate to be married. What are you desperate for? Like, what are you desperate to do? Kidnap someone? Like, I'm just confused at this like idea. But then I remember in my 20s, I mean, I always thought I was going to die anyways, but I thought I was in love at one point in my life, like in a really significant way. I thought I had found my one. And then I realized like, oh, boo, nope. You just went for another Fresh and Fit, Mr. Misogynist kind of guy who said really pretty things and were never this bad. Like, to be fair, they were never this bad. They were more like pretend to be a leftist, but not a leftist. And so when they would get upset, they'd say things like white cis men are the most discriminated group in the States. And I would sit there and look at them like, oh, boo, we live in two different realities, right? So like, that's the thing, is that all of these people come into our lives at different times. You have to know what you're seeing in order to kick the right person out. I learned the hard way, learn from my mistakes, please. I'm giving you tools to learn from my mistakes. And at the same time, I understand if you have to touch the stove first, but pay attention to the details of this man. Listen, the internet came together to mock this man with no mercy. This is important. It was like, okay, this man is like the Power Rangers, right? All of our issues that we have with humanity is represented by a color of the Power Ranger, and then this man assembled into himself with all of those issues, and that's why we all could collectively hate him. And I understand we all saw parts in him that we just like made us hate humanity, and I think that's why we can all come together, which is why ultimately I believe people are good. Because even though I do not believe in deplatforming, I do not believe in kicking this man off the internet, I believe what's important is that he can make his stance and we can make ours, and we can make it clear that like this is not everyone's reality. And that's the problem. This man got on the internet and proudly made this statement literally with no shame. I mean, I don't expect anything different from a man whose literal bedroom curtain is a shower curtain.
No, you ain't. You ain't a queen. You ain't never gonna be my queen because you ain't my mother.
Boy, you down here in the basement making more TikToks. What is wrong with you? Denisha done gone on with her life and you down here mad. I know this. I know you better go ahead and put your uniform on so I can take you up here and drop you off at Taco Bell for your shift. Now do that. And hey, don't forget your hat this time. Wait a minute. I know that's not my shower curtain you got up there at that window. Boy, when you come back from work, you put my shower curtain where it needs to be. What is wrong with you?
But let me tell you, at the same time, I feel bad for this man. I have a lot of sympathy for him. Not empathy, because I've never quite been in this situation, but I look at him and I think, I am so sorry that your mother raised you wrong, or somebody raised you wrong, or somewhere you decided this was the best idea of the world. And I ultimately hold him responsible because I believe in free will. But I'm telling you, I'm sorry. It's the probability of him not growing up in an environment that encouraged this is pretty slim, though possible, because maybe he grew up with a parent who wasn't around and so he learned it from someone else, but that's also pretty bad. So now we have to like take this into consideration. How many people do we meet who say things that really upset us and are just people who grew up fucked up? And if that's the case, like, oh, I guess humans are gonna human, right? That's ultimately what that means. Sorry, my brain slowed down because the weed hit me, and then I was like thinking about it, and I was like, wait a second. I talk about this all the time on my channel. We already know the answer. Humans gonna human. Humans are gonna human. A bunch of twos living in like cultural bubbles. Sometimes we all overlap. Most of the time, we all try to stay in our corners. But yeah, the internet came to collectively hate on this dude, and I'm not even mad about it. Like, okay, pay attention to the details. You know how the internet mostly says don't make fun of how people look, and yet we went straight for his shortness? Like, this man, like 5'2 or something, and let me tell you, I am petty, so I don't mind making fun of someone's height. And I realized because we can see someone just be so universally disliked, we can get petty and feel really good about it. When most of the time it wouldn't be the right move, right? But with him, he's just that kind of person. You're like, you know what, boo? You're not even trying, so we're not even going to try with you, right? And so they went after his height. And listen, as a girl who would date a 5'3 king like Levi any fucking day, I am 5'1. Please take note, gentlemen. I'm 5'1, 130 pounds. I am liftable, movable, bendable, flexible. Just please take note. I will take a short king. I have no issues with it. But in this moment, looking at this man, all I want to do is make fun of his height. I want to say all the things I know he thought of when he thinks of himself growing up and his insecurities. I just want to go right for the jugular, right for the jugular. And why? Because when we dislike someone, it becomes so much easier to do this and let go of our empathy and sympathy. And so I warn you today, it might be fun to indulge in your pettiness when it comes to this man on the internet because Mr. Misogyny is so easy to poke at. And so obviously on the spectrum of trash. But remember, on that spectrum, there's still really good people that are so easy to hate, but they mean the best and they're really trying and they are not the same kind of person as this man. And it's going to be very easy for you to mistake the two as the same, and they are not the same. Be very careful that you recognize what kind of a person you're dealing with. I hope this man gets help. I hope he does not kill himself from this universal bullying that is so funny and yet so real. I hope he gets therapy. I hope he talks to his mother. I hope he listens to women. I hope he listens to men. And I hope we all can have this moment together where, yes, we mock this man for being so obviously silly. And at the same time, remember to keep our pettiness at bay when it really matters.
Accountability. Something every man in his life is going to have to face if he wants to be considered and respected as a man. And I'm just gonna get straight to the point. To all the women out there that I might have offended, hurt, I'm wrong. And I sincerely apologize for that shit, bro. All I've ever wanted to do is make music since I was 16 years old. And this is not me. Heartbreak Nino is the number one music recording artist in the world. Heartbreak Nino is a billionaire. That's what Heartbreak Nino is.